Hello everyone, I Kanchan Shete, welcome back again on this lecture of Business Communication 1. In the previous lecture, we have discussed the introduction of methods of business communication as well as we have studied the meaning, advantages and disadvantages of written and oral communication. And we have also discussed the meaning, advantages and disadvantages of non-verbal communication and various forms of non-verbal communication with an examples. Today we are going to study the introduction of channels of business communication. After that we will see the meaning, advantages and disadvantages of formal communication, and lastly we will learn the meaning, advantages and disadvantages of informal communication. Friends, we know communication is an integral part of business world. In an organization, information flows forward, backwards and sideways. This flow of information is called communication. Every business firm or company establishes and develops an organizational pattern and system to carry out these activities. Generally, there is hierarchical structure in every organization to transfer and transmit the message through oral or written mode. In a hierarchical organizational structure, the board of directors decide and plan business strategies and policies which are communicated to managers or managing directors. The managing directors communicated the same information or message to divisional heads and departmental heads. These officials have the responsibility to communicate it to supervisors and executives. The supervisors and executives actually implement and guide the workers or operators to work and implement the strategy or policy. However, in hierarchical structure, the role, duties and responsibilities should clearly be defined and communicated to the concerned. There should be cordial and healthy relations among each component of hierarchical structure to avoid communication gap. So the communication channels refers to the way this information flows within the organization, which I earlier said. There are many different types of communication channels available for managers to use. This type of communication channels are grouped into two main groups, that is formal communication and informal communication. Formal communication flows along prescribed channels where all members' desires of communicating with one another are in restrict manner. So in the formal communication, there are again subtypes of channels that are vertical communication. In that, again subtype first is upward communication and second is downward communication. After that, horizontal communication and cross channel or diagonal communication. In the another side of informal communication also includes four subtypes of communication, that are first single strand chain, second is group chain, third one is cluster chain and last is probability chain. Now let's understand the meaning and advantages or disadvantages of formal communication. Friends, the communication between sender and receiver at the official level is called formal communication. The main objective of formal communication is to circulate the information or message accurately, properly, effectively and timely. This communication flows through formal channels. The formal communication can be either oral or written. So let me discuss the merits and demerits of formal communication. So the first advantage or merit of formal communication is it is generally accurate and authentic. Secondly, It has more reliability and accountability. Third is reduces the possibilities of human errors in communication. Then the message is clearly and precisely communicated. And last advantage is record can be maintained for future references. In the another side, demerits of formal communication. First is generally it is time consuming. Next is it is not natural and spontaneous. Next, not much useful in urgent communication. And last disadvantage is mainly useful for official communication. Now let's see the various types of formal communication. So the first is vertical communication. Vertical communication is the communication that flows both up and down the organization. It is the communication that takes place between managers and their superiors and subordinates. It is a kind of communication between and among different levels of authority and officials within an organization. The vision, policy, and planning in an organization flows through vertical directions. It is further divided into two parts, that is upward and downward communication. So the first, upward communication, it means the flow of information from lower level to upward level is called upward communication. It is a flow of information from bottom to top in an organizational hierarchy. There are some methods like open access. It means employees are given a feeling that they can easily and openly share and discuss problems and issues with the authorities. Then applications. Communication can be made in written to the authorities regarding personal, organizational or business matters. Next is complaints and suggestions. Complaint and suggestions can be written or oral regarding management, fellow employees, facilities, treatment, etc. Next is meeting. Formal and informal meetings are useful to discuss issues, problems and complaints. And last is reports. Reports are collected from employees at regular intervals about their progresses and experiences. Now let us see the merits and demerits of upward communication. So the first merit of upward communication is employees actively participate in policy and decision making. Second is feedback and suggestions from employees prove useful in future. Next is develops the level of understanding. Then gives direction for further improvement. And last is management gets the ideas about every individual's achievement. In the another side, demerits of upward communication. Employees may provide wrong information for their benefits. Next is proper channel of communication is not followed. Then third is lack of free expressions. Fourth is feedbacks may not reach to the higher authorities. The ego or sense of superiors may hamper upward communication. Then second type of vertical communication is downward communication. Every organization has a structural hierarchical system assigned with different duties and responsibilities. In the hierarchy, when a person at the top, an authority, passes a message or information towards downwards to the subordinates is called downward communication. In other words, it is a communication initiating from superiors and moving downwards to the subordinates through organizational hierarchy. The communication from superiors to subordinates can be either oral or written. Notices, circulars, instructions, orders, memos, emails, telephonic directions and announcements are some of the examples of downward communication. Now let's see the merits and demerits of downward communication. First is it gives subordinates clear and specific suggestion. Second advantage is makes workers aware about policies, job expectations and responsibility. Third one is helps to understand workers' role in organizational structure. Fourth merit is gives feedback to the employees about their performances. And last is helpful for proper coordination. In the another side, demerits of downward communication, it becomes one-way communication. Second is if not communicated properly may create confusion and misunderstanding. Third is mainly it is in written mode, hence lack of the benefits of oral communication. Then does not involve subordinates in policies or decision making. And last disadvantage is immediate feedback is not possible. Now let's understand the second main type of formal communication is horizontal communication. Horizontal or lateral communication in an organization flows between people of equal status, rank and positions, but in different divisions. For example, managers of production, marketing, purchase, research and development, strategic planning, etc. are of equal rank or status and positions. The communication among them is horizontal or lateral communication. This is the most frequently used channel of communication, as business today has become more complex and challenging job. It helps to coordinate among the various departments. In horizontal or lateral communication, there are various methods like face-to-face discussion, grapevine, telephonic talk, emails, teleconferencing, etc. Let's see the merits and demerits of horizontal communication. So the first merit is it is open, free and frank flow of communication. Second is helps in coordinating and exchanging information. Third merit is collectively and issues can be solved and immediate feedback is possible. Fourth advantage is it is faster and quicker, hence saves the time. Last is develops framework and sense of human hard work. Then demerits of horizontal communication. First is the spirit of competition may hamper communication. Second is people may not openly share out fear and mistrust. Third disadvantage is same kind of openness and frankness cannot be expected due to individual differences in approach. And last is lack of motivation. Now let's understand the third type of formal communication is cross-channel communication or diagonal communication. Diagonal communication is the communication that takes place between people of similar status but of different organizations. It refers to communication between managers, supervisors and subordinates belonging to different functional units. For example, when the CEO of a company communicates with the CEO of another company, it is diagonal communication or cross-channel communication. When a teacher communicates with a parent of a PTA meeting, it is useful in assignment and project-based organization. It can be written or oral. There are various methods of diagonal communication or cross-channel communication. For example, formal conferences or seminars, workshops, informal meetings, horizontal channels of communication, companies, news bulletin, suggestion box, feedback and suggestions. Let's talk about merits and demerits of diagonal or cross-channel communication. So the first advantage is it is two-way communication takes place. Then second is develops better understanding between superiors and subordinates. It involves subordinates in decision and policy making. Then immediate feedback is possible in the cross-channel communication. Next is useful to meet changing needs of business in cross-channel communication. Then demerits of cross-channel communications are it varied opinion may create conflict and groups. Second is mutual interest and benefits may be taken care. Third is may be taken as subordinates inability to take decisions. Next, insecurity of information. And last, demerit is causes disorders. Now let's understand the another channel of communication, that is informal communication. Informal communication is alternatively called grapevine. All the channels other than formal communication are called as grapevine or informal communication. It is not planned or purposefully created channel of communication. It takes place anywhere at any time when two or more members of an organization come together. It is not officially planned or sanctioned. Grapevine or informal communication takes place in informal communication or people situations, in non-planned programs and activities in an organization. For example, tea breaks, lunch and dinner time, etc. The grapevine among the authorities and employees is also helpful in motivating and raising the morale of the employees. Thus, it may prove fruitful if properly and effectively used. Let's discuss the merits and demerits of informal communication. So the first merit is it gives occasion and opportunity to workers to share their opinions, anxieties, fears and experiences. Second is it is less expensive. Then it helps to strengthen the social and personal bond among the members of an organization. Then it helps to develop cordial relations between the authorities and employees. Then it is supportive to formal. In the another side, demerits of informal communication. First is it may spread rumors and incorrect information. Second is it is less authentic and accountable. Next is it cannot be taken in black and white or on records. Then it may leads to misunderstanding. And last is it is not planned and organized. Now let us see the types of informal communication. So the first is single strand chain. In this type of chain, A tells something to B, who tells it so C, and so on it goes down to the line. This chain is the least accurate in passing on the information. Second is group or gossip chain. In this chain, person speaks out and tells everyone the information he or she has obtained. This chain is often used when information or message regarding an interesting but non-job related nature is being conveyed. Next is cluster chain. In this type of chain, A tells something to a few selected individuals and others are rely the information selectively. And fourth is probability chain. In this type of chain, individuals are indifferent to or not really interested in the persons to whom they are passing some information. They just tell random, and those people in turn tell others at random. So today's session is over. Thank you.